want to share a story of Smith Wigglesworth. He tells a story in his book on this devotional called the Smith Wigglesworth Devotional of how he was healed. He had appendicitis, and he said that he had believed God. He had prayed for 6 months for God to heal him. He had suffered in a lot of pain, and finally they brought a physician in, and the physician pretty much told him, there's no hope for you. We can't even do surgery on you. And the physician left his wife in a state of brokenness, he said, because he basically gave him a death sentence and said, there's nothing that we could do. It's too late. And he said, after the physician left, a young man and a woman, and he knew this was a woman of prayer, came and laid hands on him and prayed for him. And I'm going to read you what he says. He says that this young man jumped on the bed and commanded the evil spirit to come out of me. He shouted, come out, you devil. I command you to come out in the name of Jesus. And Smith Wigglesworth said there was no chance for an argument for me to tell him that I would never believe that there was a devil inside of me. The thing had to go in the name of Jesus, and it went. I was instantly healed. And he goes on to say that he got dressed. He said, I'm healed. I'm going to get up. I'm going to get dressed. And he was a plumber, and he had a job to do. So he went out to do the job the next day. And he said that the doctor came by looking for him and went to see him. And he said the doctor, his wife told the doctor that, well, he's not here. He went out and he went to go to work. And the doctor said, well, he's never going to come back. Your husband, the next time you see your husband, he'll be a corpse because he's going to die. And he said, I never did become a corpse. He said, and I went on, and he said, I laid hands on a great many number of people and saw them healed, and they were dressed within a quarter of an hour from the time that I prayed for him, and I saw many people healed. He said, we have a living Christ who is willing to meet people in every place. I'm going to read this quote from you. Our God is real, and he has saving and healing power today. Our Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He saves and heals today, just as of old, and he wants to be your Savior and your healer. Oh, if you would only believe God, what would happen? If you would only believe God, he's still a miracle-working God. God still does miracles. He's still the same yesterday, today, and forever. And I gave you a story of him being healed because it's a miraculous story. And I wanted to share that with you to build your faith and tell you, if you would give God all of your fears and all of your worries, if you would cast all of your cares upon the Lord, because he really does care for you, he will meet your needs. I want you to know that God cares if you have food to eat. God cares that you have all of your needs met. He's a miracle working God. We're praying for mercy. We're praying for an end to this coronavirus, that it will end as quickly as it came about. I want to share Psalm 34 and 10 with you to encourage you. This, it says, the young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. We need to give all of our burdens to the Lord. We need to truly cast them and roll them off of our shoulders and onto the shoulders of our Jesus and let him carry them and truly believe and truly trust God. If we could only believe and trust God with all of our heart, he will take care of us. So I want to read you this scripture, and you have to excuse me. We're on a farm here and there's gnats everywhere. But it says, it's Proverbs 3:1-3. It says, my son, do not fret. Do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you peace and prosperity. Keep his commands in your heart. See, Satan wants to harass you with doubt. He wants to harass you with unbelief and with worry and with fear. But if you'll refuse to let your mind turn to those evil thoughts, if you'll refuse to let your thoughts turn to fear and worry and anxiety about tomorrow, about what you'll eat, about maybe that job, maybe you have a job that's being canceled. If you'll refuse to give into that, and you will let his command sink into your heart, not your head. It's a heart faith. It's something that gets deep inside your heart and says that I know that I know that I know that I know I can trust my God. If you'll do that, he says he'll prolong your life with many years. If you'll focus and let your heart focus on his words, his commandments are his words. It's what's in the book. It's what's in the Bible. And he'll bring you peace. He'll bring you prosperity. Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Do you believe that God is true to his word? Can you really believe and really think that if God gave Jesus Christ his only son, if he gave us everything that he had and he let his son leave the throne of heaven and come down and be slaughtered and killed and shed his blood for our benefit, do you really think if he gave Jesus and he gave us everything that he has, that he won't supply our needs, that he won't take care of your financial needs, that he won't protect you, that he won't make sure that you have all that you need and protect your body and health? Trust in the Lord. You won't go hungry. He'll give us everything that we need. You won't go without. Your bills can still be paid. Your needs will be met. God will take care of us. Can you really trust God with all of your heart and not lean on your own understanding? Don't think about how you can solve your problems, but give them to him. Submit to him and let him work everything out. God won't let you down. He won't fail us. I know I can trust God to take care of me. His word will not fail. God is not a liar. His word is either real or it's not real. We either trust him or we don't trust him. It's one or the other. Don't give in to fear and unbelief. Don't give in to Satan. Don't let him harass you. Don't let him bring anxiety and fear on you. You take this stuff and you give your cares and you give them to God and you trust him and you take the word of God and you stand firm that God will meet your need. God will take care of you. He will make your path straight. He will prolong your life many years according to Proverbs 3. He will bring you peace. He will bring you prosperity. You trust in him. You stand on the word of God. Get your worship out. Get the word of God out. If there is ever a time that we have to constantly put the word in our hearts, it's now. Put the word in your heart. Put the word in your children's heart. Get together as a family around your table and talk about the goodness of God. Remember the times he saw you through those things in the past and lean not on your own understanding, but trust him and stand on his word. And I promise you, God will not fail. We don't have to fear. We don't have to worry. And all who puts their trust in him, he who keeps his mind stayed on the Lord, Isaiah 26:3 says, that man he will keep in perfect peace. So stay in peace and stay in faith and trust in God with all your heart. Amen.